Hello students, let's begin with our chapter number 6, that is circle. Now in 8th standard we have already seen what circle is and what is the chord, what is the diameter, what is the radius, what is the center. So based on that this thing is given, this table which you have to fill. Okay, this one. Okay, now the next part which is going to be used now is the circle in terms of sets of points. Okay, now the set of point in a plane which is equidistant from a fixed point in a plane is called circle. That means this is a circle. Okay, so from in the circle, all the distance here, if you take any point on the circumference of the circle, they will all be of the same distance from the center. Okay, now some terms related with the circle, that is the fixed point is called the center of the circle, segment joining the center of the circle and point on the circle is called the radius of the circle. This also you already know. Okay, after that the distance of the point on the circle from the center is also called what? Radius of the circle. Okay. Next, the segment joining any two points of a circle is called chord of the circle. And last one, the chord passing through the center of a circle is called diameter of the circle. Diameter is the largest chord. See this. Okay, now how the circles are there in the plane. Okay, first, when this radius is same, that is the same radii, they are known as congruent circle. When the center is same and outside many other circles are formed, okay, the same center of different radiuses, that type of circles are known as concentric circle. Okay, now circles touching in a point. Okay, now see the first figure, you can see here the circle is touching in one point, this point here, and here also circle is touching in one point. This one is externally touching circle and this one is internally touching centers circles. Okay, now circle intersecting in two points. See here, two points are there. This type of figure is known as circles which are intersecting in two points. Okay, here radiuses are different. Okay, and only two points are common where they are intersecting each other. Now let's go to the next page. Here properties of chord is there. This is the activity, okay, which you have to fill. Come to the theorem now. See this theorem. What the theorem says, a perpendicular drawn from the center of a circle on its chord bisect the chord. Okay, now AB is the chord here. This property you already know because you have used this property in your 8th standard. Now you are going through the theorem. Okay, so AB is the chord and OP is the perpendicular bisector. What you have to prove, that this perpendicular is bisecting the chord AB in two equal parts. Okay, that is you have to prove. See the two proof statement here. Two proof is given. AP is equal to congruent to BP. Okay, now see the proof. What is the first step? Draw OA and OB. You have to join this OA and OB. Okay, now in triangle OPA, this side, this triangle OPA and OPB. Okay, angle OPA will be equal to angle OPB because it is a perpendicular, so both the angles are 90 degree. Now OP will be equal to OP because it is the common side. Okay, now OA will be equal to OB. Why? Because see the circle is same, so from the center whichever is the line touching to the circumference of the circle, that is the circle, that is the radius. So OA will be equal to OB. Why? Because radii of the same circle. Therefore I can say triangle OPA is equal to triangle, is congruent to triangle OPB by hypotenuse side theorem. Okay, now therefore PA will be equal to PB by congruent side of similar triangle.